Kim is coming. Pam is going to share with you some of the stories that we experienced during our time at the primary and secondary schools.
And it's my pleasure to introduce you to the Brewery Primary and Secondary Schools. I don't know if many of you know, but I work at Ascension Lutheran School, and school is one of my favorite topics. So I'll try and be brief. If you see Pastor Steve going, I'll speak. Well, we visited the Brewery Primary and Secondary Schools. They have an enrollment of 1,300 students, 1,000 in the primary school and 300 in the secondary school. And I think our students here at Ascension are fabulous. And I was struck by how similar the students are at the Brewery schools as well. They're happy and they're friendly. Slide, please. And they're active. Slide, please. Actually, they're very active. Slide, please. And they talk and they sing about Jesus. And here's the third grade class. I'm going to sing for you. And very similar to our students, they are so very eager to learn. But unlike our students, they have to walk great distances to get to school. Many of them walk as long as 10 miles to get to and from school each day. And unlike our students, some of the conditions at their schools are not conducive to good learning. They have overcrowded classrooms. Next slide. And they sit on the floor because not all the students have desks. Next slide. The next slide. Actually, the only place that they have desks is in the computer lab, which your support for the electricity has brought to this remote village and brewery. They have a shipping container up in this remote area that is filled with computers. And as you can see, the students there are sitting on desks, they're sitting on chairs, and they have computer desks with computers. They consider it the most fabulous gift, and they're very grateful for it. Next slide. But here, when they're learning their core subjects, most of them don't have desks. So they're learning math and English, Shona, which is the language that they speak, sitting on the floor. The next slide, please. And because the classrooms are so overcrowded, they don't have space inside their buildings, they have outdoor classrooms as well. And on this particular day, when we visited, the temperature was 40 degrees centigrade, which is 110 degrees Fahrenheit, and they were out there learning under a tree. Next slide, please. This is the teacher housing at the primary school. You can see the pole in the background. Many of the teachers' homes do have electricity, however, some do not. But we talked to the teachers there, and they just consider it a great gift to have electricity. It's like being in the city, a few of them said, but unfortunately, not all of them have it. Next slide, please. So, the Evangelical Lutheran Church of Zimbabwe, in short, they call it the ELCZ, recognizes that they have conditions at their schools that aren't conducive to learning. And they've invited us to accompany them as they work to improve those conditions. And one of the things that they see a need for are more classrooms. And so they're seeking the support to build three additional classroom blocks, similar to these that you see up here, so that they can eliminate the overcrowding and everyone can actually sit in the building to learn. Next, please. This is a little girl. She looks very happy there, right? And she's one of the lucky ones that gets to sit in a desk. But the ELCZ wants all of their students to actually be able to sit in desks. So they're seeking support in order to buy the amount of desks needed so that all of their students can actually have comfortable learning conditions. The next slide, please. These are some of the teachers at the Brewery Primary School. And one of the things that the ELCZ has recognized is in order to retain and recruit teachers, they need to make their conditions, their living conditions, as comfortable as possible. And while some have electricity, not all do. And so they want to be able to wire all of their staff housing for the electricity. Next, please. And these are a couple of students that were in the info hut, and they were expressing their thanks for your support and for the fact that they have electricity, so now they can learn on computers. And so you can't see it on their screen, but I'll read it to you. They're saying, "We are very excited to meet you. We love you." And in their own voices, they express their gratitude. Let's listen to them sing.
I'll say that they call our ELCA
Galpa.
What we can achieve through our partnership together. Our ELC global mission of model is accompaniment. We've heard them talk about accompaniment. It means walking together. We walk side by side in this work that God has called us to. We pray. We share these stories. I invite you to continue to share some of these stories with your family and friends. And then to give as God leads you locally, LSS, globally, to one of these projects in Brewery. I want to see a mighty flood of justice, an endless river of righteous living. Let justice roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. We want to be like those five wise bridesmaids who are ready for the Lord's coming. Today the Lord comes to us through the least of these, our brothers and sisters. Through the people across the street, here in the Conejo Valley, and to the people across the ocean as well. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for these opportunities, these blessings, to be in partnership with people serving here in Conejo Valley through LSS, as we'll hear more next week about, and as we've heard today in Bururi, and in Zambia, and in Tanzania. Lord, bless them, bless those ministries. Thank you for our partnership. In Jesus' name, amen.